How's it going, guys? Space Lord here, bringing another What Is video. Today I'm playing Xenonauts. This is a game I started to make a What Is video on a blind playthrough, and I found it to be very confusing, so I spent most of my time just trying to figure out what to even do. So, unlike my usual What Is videos, this one I did actually play for, I played for a couple hours on a different game. To get a sense of how to play it, because it's kind of complicated. And now I'm going to start a new game because that game actually went badly. Alright, so I'll go ahead and start a new game. We'll do normal. And, begin game. Alright, so this is basically kind of a remake of the old XCom game, in a way. So if you're not familiar with the sort of premise, the idea is that Earth is under attack by aliens, and you're this sort of special organization designed to deal with it. That's the gist of it. I mean, there's a lot of lore and interesting stuff going on, but that's the basic idea. So the first thing you need to do when you get started is build a base. Last time I went with the United States, but I wasn't paying attention to the money. You can see up there in the upper right, up here, that became one of my big issues. Actually, it looks like, because I built my first one here and the second one in Africa, because I was trying to grab a lot of land space, but as you can see, Africa really doesn't donate that much money. Central America is very low. But maybe I can kind of grab a bit here. I think that my old choice was actually a good one. So I'm going to go ahead and go here because America is the number one donator. Because I was having a lot of trouble with money before. Alright, so there we go. Let's get into our base. Your first base, they kind of set you up nicely. Alright, so I have a drop ship. I have a couple planes. That's enough for now. So these planes here are your interceptors. They shoot down the UFOs, and you have a dropship, which basically what you want to do is you want to shoot down the plane and then, or shoot down the UFO and then go to the location. And alien invasion. Let me get my troops set up. So, alright. So you have little squads of eight guys, and you can change the roles and stuff. So these are all, and then I have a couple in reserve. It's good to have reserve because when guys get wounded, you can kind of pull them out. One thing I learned that's very important, like the problem is whenever you go to get in the place, these guys are both assault. They have high hit points. I'm actually going to switch them over to shield guys. Because it's super hard, I found, to get into the UFO when you're, you'll be on a map, and you'll see when I get my first one. But you actually have to kind of break into the UFO ship, and it's really hard to do that without dying. Because their equipment is much better. The shield guys are pretty good because they can sort of absorb a lot of damage. Alright, so I have two shields, a sniper, rifleman, heavy weapons. I've never really used. I'll keep it for now. Three riflemen. We'll keep it like that. Alright, so I think I have everything I need. So we'll go ahead and speed things up. Alright, so this is just the background, it kind of tells you we're being invaded. Alright, so I can do research. The Hunter Scout car, it's kind of like a little light infantry vehicle. Well, not really an infantry vehicle because it doesn't have any troops, but it's a little armored car. And it helps a lot because it's very easy to get your guys killed. So, I'll get that research. So you can see, like, there's things going up here. Communication disruption, freak storm. This is the signs that there's a UFO up there. But my base here, this blue circle, is the radar range, so I can't really see what's going on over there yet. Now there's some stuff in South America. And right now, since I only have one base, I basically need to wait until it gets up in my range. This is a problem I had, and I don't know. I'm not sure what the best decision is, because before I was building bases to kind of get my radar range spread around so I could catch these UFOs. But then it ended up eating up all my money, and I hardly had any money for actually getting good equipment. So I found myself spread really thin. But my worry is that if I don't protect these regions, then they're going to cut off my funding. So I'm not sure how to balance that. Okay, so we have a small UFO right here. In the beginning game, they're really easy. So we'll dispatch those two Condors, fighter planes, to go and intercept. We'll speed up a little bit. All right, they're over the Gulf of Mexico right now. And if you shoot them down there, basically you can't get any benefits. So I'm going to tail till they come over land. What happened? I'm not sure why. Alright, I'm not sure why he's just circling instead of engaging. I mean, it's over land, right? Okay, let me just see what happens. Did it crash? I'm not sure what's going on. Alright, I'm just going to tell him to engage. Huh. Weird, I've actually never seen this happen. Intercept. I guess it landed. Alright, so I got my dropship. I'm going to send it out. Okay. Yeah, I guess it landed. I've never actually seen one like land like that. Huh. Local authorities. Alright, so if it gets back up, my interceptor's gonna nab it otherwise. Oh, okay, so it's overland. So yeah, I guess it landed. Alright, so auto resolve. Alright. You can go into a little battle screen, but I don't know, I don't like it. It's very clunky, and every time I do it, I just blow up my ship. So, and it's not even that interesting. So, alright, so there we go. Shot down the UFO. That guy can go back to the base. Let's see, crash site. Okay, so it's heading there. Alright. There we go. And we'll engage. And this is this part here where you actually move in with your dropship. This is kind of the main part of the game, if you will. It's the fun part. It's the ground combat. When you shoot one down, you can also just sort of do an airstrike on it. But you get some money from that, but you don't get any technology or anything. So, alright, so this is the screen. It's all turn-based. I got my shield guys. I'm going to keep them out kind of in front. Oh, man, he's right there. Alright, so it's a little bit blocked by the cacti. What about now? Still. Take another step. Sheesh. Alright, well, I'm just going to go ahead and kneel down right here. Take a shot. There we go. It's better to be safe. Where's my other shield guy? Can he move out? Yep. Alright, he might get a better shot. Kneel down. And you can go through several levels, and you see it takes 18 points. The points are right here. And so it takes 18 points for that, 25. It's a better aim. You can see the chance of hitting goes up. So I'll go ahead and do that kind of shot. Missed. These guys are really terrible when they first start. You gotta work them up. Next I want to try to get my sniper back here. That's going to take, I want to save enough for a normal shot. So you can kind of limit your movement. I don't know if that's gonna work. Okay, it is. It's a clear shot. Alright, we'll go ahead and take the shot. Alright, 26 damage. There's different kinds of aliens too. These reptile guys, they take quite a bit of damage. They tend to be a lot more deadly up close. Alright, so... Trying to avoid getting guys killed. Do I have any sort of shot here? I can take a little bit. It's unlikely to hit, but I prefer to be safe. Ooh, got him. Excellent. Alright, I'm going to just go ahead and move my other guys out. So, we're in... One thing that's really neat about this game, so like this, the crash was in like Central America, Mexico, something like that. And so the environment reflects that. You can see it's like desert and stuff like that. If it crashes near a city, then it'll have like an urban environment. So, alright, so the aliens are out there moving around. It's not too bad at first. It gets hard really quick. So if you kind of mess up, it's kind of snowballs on you. And you gotta be careful too, because these guys, oh that's cool, a little gas station. These guys can really kind of sneak up on you. So you really want to make sure you cover your area as well. Alright, so there's a couple civilians. They're suppressed. So that tells me that, you know, somebody's shooting at him over here. Alright, there he is. There's the guy. Very low chance of hitting that. I'm going to take... Oh. Nope, don't have enough. It's red. 18 points. Okay. So, does he have any... Alright, so I can shift him. There's probably no chance at all. Where's my sniper? There he is. Alright, we can move him. I'm going to make sure he has enough for a normal shot. Alright, this is going to be quite a long shot, but snipers can sometimes pull it off. Alright, 55% chance. Nope. Okay. And I'm not too worried about him sort of hitting me from here. Because like I said, they are not very good at long range. Part of their like bio, as you find out as you play, is that they have sort of short range eyesight. Okay, that's nice. This dude. Now, I've never actually used the assault. So he just has burst. Yeah, so he's not going to be able to shoot. I'm going to kind of move him up as close as I can and then kneel. And then maybe next round I'll get to do some burst fire. These guys, he can make a normal shot with 17. Do we get a clean shot? No, it says 18. Why is... Oh, because he's not facing. That's the problem. 1 point to move. Alright, so these guys aren't really going to be able to... We'll just get them moved up a little. There we go. Shield guy has a little bit of movement. I'm going to move him... right here. Oh, there's another one. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and duck him down there. Alright, those guys, those civilians are kind of screwed. You're supposed to try to protect them, but not much chance of that happening. Ooh, see? That killed my guy right there. Until you get armor, it's pretty much they kill you dead on. Alright, so he's got a burst shot. 27, alright, times 10. Well, he needs 44. He's got some movement, so let's move up. No, he basically doesn't. So, let's just shoot. That was pretty good, actually. Wow. Maybe I should start using those guys more. Alright, move up my shield guy. I spotted one over there. I'm going to move right here. There's a little bit of cover. Duck down. Maybe take a normal little pot shot here. Got lucky. Move this guy kind of here. And then duck down. Mostly I want the shield guys to kind of draw the fire. Can't believe they took that dude out like that. Ugh. Alright, move him up. Duck. Let's get these guys buying cover. One thing that really annoys me about this game is if they spot an alien sort of coming towards them, they will sort of react and shoot, which is fine, except they will shoot each other in the back of the head and stuff, so you can't, you gotta watch how you place them. It's a little retarded. There's no, see, there is a reaction shot. That was a good reaction shot. So in other words, you don't want them in a line. You want them sort of in a line horizontally to targets. Alright, so there's just one right now. I want to try this machine gun guy again. I'm a little afraid for this person. So let's move her down here. Just to make sure this guy doesn't machine gun him. Alright, take a shot. Nice. Machine gunner. I'm actually thinking I should have been using these machine gun guys. Wow. Yeah, they're really good for the open field. That perhaps was part of my problem. Alright, I know there was another one, I think, that ran off that way. The main thing you gotta do is you gotta find the UFO ship. Alright, don't see anybody, but I know there's one over this way. I'll duck him down there. His shield protects him from the front, but if a guy comes up this way, it's kind of a bad situation. That person's moved. Alright, these guys I'll bring up position and cover. This civilian needs to get the hell out. Little cover there. I want to keep an eye on this gas station just in case. Where can you go? Can't quite make it there. Maybe here. It's better than nothing. And duck. And then Mr. Machine Gun Guy. Oop. Take a step forward. Alright. Where are you going, dude? You're running in the direction of the aliens. You should run behind the armed humans trying to save you. Alright, I'm gonna inch this guy up a little. You gotta be careful, because this game is very unforgiving. Face. And duck. So you have to move very carefully. This side maybe. Okay. Looking pretty clear. So these guys, just go ahead and shift up. Duck them down. Who's that? That's my machine gun guy, rifleman. Kind of put here. And good, I wanted to face that direction just in case. And then him. He's kind of lagging behind here. I'm gonna. Can you move all the way up here? Yeah, alright. Duck down. And turn. Alright. So that guy seems to be getting out. You get extra points if the civilians live. Alright, so move up with my shield guys first. Did he spot someone? No. inch up a little further. Go ahead and stop there. And sometimes they'll just run back to their ship. Okay, is this the end of the map? I think it might be. Yep, that's the end of the map. Okay, so must have booked it up there. Unless... okay. Sometimes they'll hide and get you too. You gotta be careful. I think if he was... there's only one square he could be hiding in, and I think if he was there, he would have came out already. Move my guys up, keep moving carefully. You really do have to be super methodical here. If you try any sort of Rambo stuff, you just, your whole team dies. There we go. And okay, so this person I'm gonna face that way to keep some visual on that direction. Okay. Still nothing, okay. Boop that way. Alright, there's the ship. That's our target. Get them shifted up. And the rest of the team I'm just gonna hang out so that my shield guys can stay up front. Take the lead on this. There might actually be a guy hanging out in there. Probably not. It really sucks when you get kind of those surprises. You think you have an area cleared and then a guy pops up from nowhere. Okay. All right. They'll sort of pop out of their ship sometimes too, especially when you get up front. All right, let's go ahead and move up here. Face and kneel, get positioned in front of that door. Guys on the flank side of the ship. Alright. End the turn. He might pop the door open. Nope. Okay. And if they're like hiding out here, if you occupy their ship for 5 turns, then that's considered a victory too. Alright, so they're in position. I'm gonna get all my guys like really close so that they're ready for action. You really need to like throw in like a flashbang or something and use shields, because it puts you at close quarters with those energy weapons, and those weapons just demolish you. Nope, okay. Let's see what happens. Step through. Alright, there's 2 guys in there. Okay, can I throw a flashbang? Throw it. Alright, suppressed them both. I'm gonna duck. This person, I'm gonna go ahead and take some shots here. Miss. Are you kidding me? Alright, this dude. He needs 44 for burst. I don't know if he's gonna completely gun down. Nope, he's got a clear shot. There we go. That does amazing damage. Kind of stepping back. No. See, I think I can shoot over a kneeling person. Whew, not shooting like that. Is he got enough to kneel? It is 3 to kneel. Alright. Alright, we'll go ahead and end the turn. Oh, okay, so he hit the shield, that's good. Stupid door closed. I'm gonna step him in a few paces. Face, kneel, take a shot. Of course he missed. Oh, he's up. He emptied it out. That took his turn, basically. Which kind of sucks. Kneel down, take a shot. Good, take another shot. Alright, suppressed. Excellent. Alright, so I'm gonna step her in over here. No, here. Take some shots. Ah, it's ridiculous messing at that range. Alright, dead. I'm thinking. Alright, mission successful. Alright, so my experience from before really helped me out there, because I know in my first couple missions, my first playthrough, I just got wiped out. Alright, so I lost one guy. That was unfortunate. One of the civilians survived. Five aliens dead. And we got some research stuff. Alright, and we got 27,000 from some gear. Alright. So now I can research stuff. When you find stuff, you can research it. Let's see, I'm trying to remember. Alright, so we're still working on the scout car. The next thing I want to work on is the plasma rifle. It lets you get the armor, basically. Let's check on my guys. Alright, so we're one man short now. I'm not sure who died. Or did they recover? I thought I had... See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, no. Okay. So I got my heavy weapons guy. I have two shields. So I guess it was just a rifleman. Between these two, this person looks better. Won't let me? Is my squad full? Am I confused? Oh, they haven't returned yet. Alright. Gotta wait for them to get back before I can mess with that. Alright, speed up time. Come back home. So a pretty good start. Alright, so now I can go in there. Take a look. Alright, so we're missing one person, yeah. And then I'll assign this person into Charlie 1 as rifleman. We can check him out here. Everybody's doing good now. This heavy weapon guy, I tell you, it's made me a convert. Tore them up. Alright, so the heavy weapon guy is really good. So now, basically you speed up time till something happens. Alright, so they did at the autopsy, and it kind of gives you a nice big description of them. This is where it tells you, basically they have thick skin, resistant to damage, but kind of close range eyesight. You can check out their scout UFO too. Alright, armored car has been researched. So we can go to the research screen, and we're going to work on the pistol first. And now we can work on the scout car. There are new free garage slots. Alright. So we need to build a garage. So this is your base. And basically it's just modular. You build whatever you need to build in here. So I'll just pop a garage right there. Take 5 days to build. And up here is where the time runs. It's pretty, you know, like, this is actually all happening pretty fast. So even if I speed up, you know, it's just a matter of days. Alright, so like 2 days later, there was another UFO. We'll intercept it with our condors again. Launch them out. Oop. We're gonna tail to overland. Speed up a little. Come on. Sometimes they never go overland. Oh, there we go. Engage. And these guys are easy. Alright, so they're taken down. I think my team's ready. No one's hurt. I do want to go ahead and, since I only have one sort of reserve soldier, I'm going to get a couple more, because it takes a few days to get them, so, you know, you don't want to be short on your team. I'm going to get one person with high hit points. What's the qualities in the heavy weapons guy? What's his strength, I imagine? Accuracy. Alright. So I want to make sure I have a guy that can kind of do that. Oops, I didn't hire that last person. So we'll get that person, and then strength, reflexes, bravery. This one looks a little better. I'll get that one. Maybe one more with a high accuracy. This one has a lot of actually good qualities. All right, so we'll hire those three. All right. Oh, hire selected. There we go. And you can see the funds up there. Right now I have 1,447,000, which doesn't last as long as you think, because things get expensive. All right, so let's get the crash site. We can see you can airstrike it for 15,000, but you don't get any resurgence. So it's not something you want to do unless your team is, like, you know, all hurt and you can't deal with it. What I did in my last game is I sort of set up just a little base with those interceptors over here to shoot down the UFOs, because if you don't shoot them down, they cause problems like this and the countries get mad. And so I'd shoot them down, I would just do airstrikes. The dropships, so the interceptors, they have a limited range. They'll run out of fuel really quick. The dropships, you can go anywhere in the world, but, you know, if you only have one and you go all the way over there, it can take a long time. I had two my last game, but it was really chewing up the money, and it was kind of spreading me thin. I think it might be better just to have one dropship and constantly sort of, I don't know, moving around, and then if you have more crash sites, then just do airstrikes on them or whatever. At least for a while. I don't know. I don't know the best way to go for that. All right. Don't have my scout vehicle yet. Bad thing about scout vehicle, though, is they can't go into the UFO. All right, so there's some doofus standing out there. And we got a copper over there. All right. Get the shield guys out front. All right, urban. Urban's rough. You never know where they're going to come from. Kind of position him there. Try to get some sight. Oh, there we go. Right there. All right. Go ahead, duck down. Can we get a shot in? No. So this guy's actually in a little bit of a bad situation. Here? No, I think it'll be out of the area. Alright, who do we got? Sniper guy. Sniper guy, I'm gonna put him back. I'm afraid of somebody coming in through here. I'm just gonna put him. Yeah, I'll put him here. Can we take a shot? It's blocked 100%. Not gonna happen. That means he can't shoot there. This dude. Let's get him rolled up, set up here. This guy steps out. Machine gun his face off. And so the other guys, I'm just gonna kind of bring up against this wall. I'm actually gonna have him look through this window. Looks okay. Have him kind of looking through this window. You know, there could be a guy in here and he pops out and all of a sudden bad things are happening. Okay. Looks good in turn. Somebody's shooting where? I don't know. I think there's more guys in that building. That guy's taking off. Who's shooting at him? Was somebody shooting at him from up here? Alright, so this guy ducked into this building. I don't know if these... Oh, these doors do open. Alright. I want him to kind of be here, but kind of looking that way. More like that way. Just to cover that flank. This shield guy, I'm going to run up to this door. Alright, there he is. He's chilling back there. Can I get up here? Not quite. What about here? You know, I'm just going to duck him there. Alright, my machine gunner, can he get all the way up here? He can. He's going to hop over that. Ooh, there's more. Alright. Go there, duck down. Just be ready. Be ready, bro. Bring them up. And can I get up here? Where is this? This is a little raised area. And there's actually a cop in there. Mouse wheel lets you scroll up and down among the levels, and this too. Alright. Just gonna come up here for now. So this sniper back here is not really doing too much good. I'm gonna bring him back here just to... Oh. Yep. There's a guy all the way over there. This sniper might actually be able to get a beat on him. Yeah. Take a shot. Ooh, nice. Nice. Alright, so we kinda got guys everywhere. So I don't know if you can like... No, the car's blocking. Alright, we'll end up down there. Who else do we have? This person. I'm gonna go ahead and sweep through this building. Just to make sure. Alright. Let's see what happens. Oop. Taken to the higher level. He's moving in. Cops dug it out. Alright, so this guy's up there. Can I shoot him? Yes. Nice. Tore that dude up. Alright, so then this guy's coming in on me. Got my sniper. Take a good shot. It's pretty good. And take another quick shot. No. What about him? Can he... Oh, I can shoot through here, apparently. I guess it's a glass. Alright, take a good shot. That wasn't a good shot. Take another shot. Whew. Alright, I'm doing fairly okay this time. It's making me nervous. I'm gonna advance this guy. Just to kind of check on what's going on back here. Okay. And turn. And duck. That way I got that alleyway back there covered. Because I know there's a dude back there. Move him up a little. Can't get over there. Can't duck down though. Alright, so we'll move him. Who else do I have? Alright, she can come up here. And... No. She'll hang there for now. This person, I'm gonna advance up the street a little. Keep an eye on things. Alright. End the turn. He's creeping around somewhere. This poor guy. He's running around like crazy. Where'd that guy go? Ducked out. It's probably a mistake. There's a lot of ways it could have gone. Oh, he's not back here. Oh! There he is, he's in the building. I didn't even spot him. Alright. Took a shot, it's a bad shot, but it worked out. It worked out. This dude, I want to get in there. 13. Alright. If I can just get him in there and get him ducked down, he'll be in a good position. That dude moved. Got another shield person. Flank him. Duck down. Shoot him. There we go. This person I'm gonna keep them. Just keep advancing up the street a little bit. Don't think any more guys is gonna help this situation in there. Just like go look in the window. Nope. Okay. Face him that way, duck him down. Sniper dude, just move up a little. And who else we got left? This person. Can we make it all the way up here? Run out of right here. Keep moving up. And this person, we'll just go ahead and move up here. That would be down to one movement. She'll stay there. Okay. Oof, blew out the shield. The shield's gonna only take so many hits. Same with body armor. Alright, can this guy gun him? Gun him down. There we go. That guy's my star, man. Oh, there's a ship back there. Nice. Alright, so let's begin moving down this way. No casualties yet in this mission. Alright, so this shield person's kind of useless now. Because when they have a shield, all they have is a pistol. So, kind of worst. Oh. Alright. There we go. Nope. Guy's trucking around. Let's get my shield guy up front. Duck him down. Rifleman here. Just gonna kinda keep her in the back. People moved over. This person, I'm gonna face that way. Just keep an eye on things. My machine gun. Come on, man. Alright. Oh, you idiot. Oh, and he turned around. I mean, I don't blame him, but... Ugh, So now my shield man's bleeding because of this moron shot him in the ass. Alright, turn back around. You can take a shot, at least. Alright, missed. Alright, so there is med packs. You can heal people a little bit. Alright, this idiot. It's kind of exposed here, but we'll just take a good shot. Okay. Not you. Machine gun dude. Maybe here. It's a little precarious, but I'm gonna do it. Okay, he's spent his turn healing. Duck down. Ugh. I'm a sniper back. Get over there. Okay, duck down. Alright, intern. We might lose some guys here. Ugh. I have no shield guys now. This rough situation. Alright. Where's my... Light this dude up. Well, didn't kill him. Suppressed him, though. Alright. You need to re-enable your gun. And... turn... kneel. I don't think there's a lot more guys in there, but... pistol broad, sniper dude. This is a really tough place to engage from, I have to say. I'm gonna position the sniper over here. Hopefully he can get a shot later. I'm kind of moved up. Alright, I don't know if they're going to pop out. I think there's only one more in there. Okay. Nope, we need to reload. I'm trying to think of the best way to do this. If I can move up, sort of open the door, and then get a flashbang off. Is he dead? That guy's dead. Alright, so... not enough points. Alright. So I can just kneel down. I'm gonna hold off. Have him throw one. Okay, that suppressed him. I can't kneel down. Move her up. Alright, hopefully this guy doesn't just massacre all my dudes. I don't think I have a shot here. Chance to hit my own guy. Alright, here we go. Yep. Wow. Just sniped him in the back of the head. These people are so stupid with their reflex shots. It's so stupid. I mean, come on. What kind of soldier takes a shot right to the back of the dude's head? Alright, so hopefully that's it. Whew. Alright. I lost one guy. One guy, but everybody else survived, so it's hard to make it through with everybody living. This guy got 2 kills. He's injured. He got the Order of Gallantry. Alright. So got some stuff there. Everything worked out. And then they head back home. So, I mean, basically, in a nutshell, that's the game. As you play through, you're able to get more advanced stuff. Like, you eventually get some different armor and other weapons as you research. Like, you get laser guns and stuff. You get vehicles. Let's see if it's, like, the Hunter Scout car. I think if I click over here. So, yeah, no armor yet. Alright, so yeah, the armored scout car can be really good to kind of have out front. So that your guys don't get chewed up as bad, kind of from like those surprise attacks. But it's really not useful whenever you're trying to get inside the UFO. So in that case, it's kind of bad. But overall, I mean, you can advance stuff. You can get new planes, better planes and stuff that are faster and can go further and stuff. I'm sure there's a lot of other stuff, too, that I haven't gotten to. But basically, that's the game. So, you know, if you like strategy games, and especially if you like tactical combat, I think this game's highly recommended. Again, this is coming from someone who's never played the original XCOM, so... You know, this is my first experience of it, and if this is like the original, then I can see why it's such a classic, great game. So, check it out. If you like this video, please take a second, scroll down, you know, give me a thumbs up, and subscribe if you're not. I bring out new videos every day. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. The sniper back here is not really doing too much good. I'm gonna bring him back here just to. Oh. Yep. There's a guy all the way over there. This sniper might actually be able to get a beat on him. Yeah. Take a shot. Ooh, nice. Nice, nice. Alright, so we kind of got guys everywhere. So, I don't know if you can, like, no, the car's blocking. Alright, we'll go and duck down there. Who else do we have? This person. I'm gonna go ahead and sweep through this building. Just to make sure. Alright. Let's see what happens. Ooh. Taken to the higher level. He's moving in. Cops dug it out. Alright, so this guy's up there. Can I shoot him? Yes. Nice. Tore that dude up. Alright, so then this guy's coming in on me. Got my sniper. Take a good shot. It's pretty good. And take another quick shot. No. What about him? Can he? Oh, I can shoot through here apparently. I guess it's a glass. Alright, take a good shot. That wasn't a good shot. Alright, take another shot. Whew! Alright, I'm doing fairly okay this time. It's making me nervous. I'm gonna advance this guy. Just to kind of check on what's going on back here. Okay. And turn and duck. That way I got that alleyway back there covered. Because I know there's a dude back there. Move him up a little. Can't get over there. Can't duck down though. Alright, so we'll move him. Who else do I have? Alright, she can come up here. And no. She'll hang there for now. This person, I'm gonna advance up the street a little. Keep an eye on things. Alright. End of turn. He's creeping around somewhere. This poor guy. He's running around like crazy. Where'd that guy go? Ducked out. It's probably a mistake. There's a lot of ways it could have gone. Oh, he's not back here. Oh! There he is. He's in the building. I didn't even spot him. Alright. Took a shot. It's a bad shot, but it worked out. It worked out. This dude, I want to get in there. 13. Alright. I think just get him in there and get him ducked down. He'll be in a good position. That dude moved. Got another shield person. Flank him. Duck down. Shoot him. There we go. This person I'm gonna keep them. Just keep advancing up the street a little bit. Don't think any more guys is going to help this situation in there. Just like go look in the window. Nope. Okay. Face him that way, duck him down. Sniper dude, just move up a little. And who else we got left? This person. Can we make it all the way up here? Run out of right here. Keep moving up. And this person, we'll just go ahead and move up here. That would be down to one movement. She'll stay there. Okay. Woof. Blew out the shield. The shield's gonna take so many hits. Same with body armor. Alright, can this guy gun him? Gun him down. There we go. That guy's my star, man. Oh, there's a ship back there. Nice. Alright, so let's begin moving down this way. No casualties yet in this mission. Alright, so this shield person's kind of useless now. Because when they have shield, all they have is a pistol. So, kind of worst. Oh. Alright. There we go. Oh. Guy's trucking around. Let's get my shield guy up front. Duck him down. Rifleman here. Just gonna kinda keep her in the back. My people moved over. This person on my face that way, just keep an eye on things. My machine gun. Come on, man. Alright. Oh. Oh, you idiot. Oh, pff. And he turned around. I mean, I don't blame him, but... Ugh. So now my shield man's bleeding because of this moron shot him in the ass. Alright. Turn back around. You can take a shot, at least. Alright, missed. Alright, so there is med packs. You can heal people a little bit. Alright, this idiot. It's kind of exposed here, but... we'll just take a good shot. Okay. Not you. Machine gun board. Alright. Where are you going, dude? You're running in the direction of the aliens. You should run behind the armed humans trying to save you. Alright, I'm gonna inch this guy up a little. Gotta be careful, because this game is very unforgiving. Face. And duck. So you have to move very carefully. This side maybe. Okay. Looking pretty clear. So these guys, just go ahead and shift up. Duck them down. Who's that? That's my machine gun guy. Rifleman. I'll put it here. And good, I wanted to face that direction just in case. And then him. He's kind of lagging behind here. I'm gonna... Can you move all the way up here? Yeah, alright. Duck down. And turn. Alright, so that guy seems to be getting out. You get extra points if the civilians live. Alright, so move up with my shield guys first. Did you spot someone? No. Inch up a little further. Go ahead and stop there. And sometimes they'll just run back to their ship. Okay, is this the end of the map? I think it might be. Yep, that's the end of the map. Okay, so must have booked it up there. Unless... Okay. Sometimes they'll hide and get you too. You gotta be careful. I think if he was, there's only one square he could be hiding in, and I think if he was there, he would have came out already. Move my guys up, keep moving carefully. You really do have to be super methodical here. If you try any sort of Rambo stuff, you just, your whole team dies. There we go. And okay, so this person I'm gonna face that way to keep some visual on that direction. Okay. Still nothing, okay. Boop that way. Alright, there's the ship. That's our target. Get them shifted up. And the rest of the team I'm just gonna hang out so that my shield guys can stay up front. Take the lead on this. There might actually be a guy hanging out in there. Probably not. It really sucks when you get kind of those surprises. You think you have an area cleared and then a guy pops up from nowhere. Okay. Alright. They'll sort of pop out of their ship sometimes too, especially when you get up front. Alright, let's go ahead and move up here. I'll face and kneel, get positioned in front of that door. Guys on the flank side of the ship. Alright. End of turn. He might pop the door open. Nope. Okay. And if they're like hiding out here, if you occupy their ship for 5 turns, then that's considered a victory too. Alright, so they're in position. I'm going to get all my guys like really close so that they're ready for action. You really need to like throw in like a flashbang or something and use shields, because it puts you at close quarters with those energy weapons, and those weapons just demolish you. Nope. Okay. Let's see what happens. Step through. Alright, there's 2 guys in there. Okay, can I throw a flashbang? Throw it. Alright, suppress them both. I'm gonna duck. This person, I'm gonna go ahead and take some shots here. Miss. Are you kidding me? Alright, this dude. He needs 44 for burst. I don't know if he's gonna completely gun down. Nope, he's got a clear shot. There we go. Guy does amazing damage. Can I step him back? No. So yeah, I think I can shoot over a kneeling person. Whew, not shooting like that. Has he got enough to kneel? It is 3 to kneel. Alright. Alright, we'll go ahead and end the turn. Oh, okay, so he hit the shield, that's good. Stupid door closed. gonna step him in a few paces. Face, kneel, take a shot. Of course he missed. Oh, he's up. He emptied it out. That took his turn, basically. Which kind of sucks. Kneel down, take a shot. Good, take another shot. Alright, suppressed. Excellent. Alright, so I'm gonna step her in. Over here? No, here? Take some shots. Ah, it's ridiculous messing at that range. Alright, dead. I'm thinking. Alright, mission successful. Alright, so my experience from before really helped me out there, because I know in my first couple missions, my first playthrough, I just got wiped out. Alright, so I lost one guy. That was unfortunate. One of the civilians survived. Five aliens dead. And we got some research stuff. Alright, and we got 27,000 from some gear. Alright. So now I can research stuff. When you find stuff, you can research it. Let's see, I'm trying to remember. Alright, so we're still working on the scout car. The next thing I want to work on is plasma rifle. It lets you get the armor, basically. Let's check on my guys. Alright, so we're one man short now. How's it going, guys? Space Lord here. Bringing another What Is video. Today I'm playing Xenonauts. This is a game I started to make a What Is video on a blind playthrough, and I found it to be very confusing, so I spent most of my time just trying to figure out what to even do. So, unlike my usual What Is videos, this one I did actually play for, you know, I played for a couple hours on a different game to get a sense of how to play it, because it's kind of complicated. And now I'm going to start a new game because that game actually went badly. Alright, so I'll go ahead and start a new game. We'll do normal. And, begin game. Alright, so this is basically kind of a remake of the old XCOM game in a way. So if you're not familiar with the sort of premise, the idea is that Earth is under attack by aliens, and you're this sort of special organization designed to deal with it. That's the gist of it. I mean, there's a lot of lore and interesting stuff going on, but that's the basic idea. So the first thing you need to do when you get started is build a base. Last time I went with the United States, but I wasn't paying attention to the money. You can see up there in the upper right, up here, that became one of my big issues. Actually, it looks like, because I built my first one here and the second one in Africa, because I was trying to grab a lot of land space, but as you can see, Africa really doesn't donate that much money. Central America is very low. But maybe I can kind of grab a bit here. I think that my old choice was actually a good one. So I'm going to go ahead and go here, because America is the number one donator. Because I was having a lot of trouble with money before. Alright, so there we go. Let's get into our base. Your first base, they kind of set you up nicely. Alright, so I have a drop ship. I have a couple planes. That's enough for now. So these planes here are your interceptors. They shoot down the UFOs, and you have a drop ship, which basically what you want to do is you want to shoot down the plane and then, or shoot down the UFO and then go to the location. And alien invasion. Let me get my troops set up. So, all right. So you have little squads of eight guys. and you can change the roles and stuff. So these are all, and then I have a couple in reserve. It's good to have reserve because when guys get wounded, you can kind of pull them out. One thing I learned that's very important, like, the problem is whenever you go to get in the place, these guys are both assault. They have high hit points. I'm actually going to switch them over to shield guys. Because it's super hard, I found, to get into the UFO when you're, you know, like, you'll be on a map, and you'll see when I get my first one. But you actually have to kind of break into the UFO ship, and it's really hard to do that without dying. Because their equipment is much better. The shield guys are pretty good because they can sort of absorb a lot of damage. Alright, so I have two shields, a sniper, rifleman, heavy weapons. I've never really used. I'll keep it for now. Three riflemen. We'll keep it like that. Alright, so I think I have everything I need. So we'll go ahead and speed things up. Alright, so this is just the background, you know, it kind of tells you we're being invaded. Alright, so I can do research. The Hunter Scout car, it's kind of like a little light infantry vehicle. Well, not really an infantry vehicle because it doesn't have any troops, but it's a little armored car. And it helps a lot because it's very easy to get your guys killed. So, I'll get that research. So you can see, like, there's things going up here. Communication disruption, freak storm. This is the signs that there's a UFO up there. But my base here, this blue circle, is the radar range. So I can't really see what's going on over there yet. Now there's some stuff in South America. And right now, since I only have one base, I basically need to wait until it gets up in my range. This is a problem I had, and I don't know. I'm not sure what the best decision is, because before I was building bases to kind of get my radar range spread around so I could catch these UFOs. But then it ended up eating up all my money, and I hardly had any money for actually getting good equipment. So I found myself spread really thin. But my worry is that if I don't protect these regions, then they're going to cut off my funding. So I'm not sure how to balance that. Okay, so we have a small UFO right here. In the beginning game, they're really easy. So we'll dispatch those two Condors, fighter planes, to go and intercept. We'll speed up a little bit. All right, they're over the Gulf of Mexico right now. And if you shoot them down there, basically, you can't get any benefits. So I'm going to tail till they come over land. What happened? Not sure why. Alright, I'm not sure why he's just circling instead of engaging. I mean, it's over land, right? Okay, let me just see what happens. Did it crash? I'm not sure what's going on. Alright, I'm just going to tell them to engage. Huh. Weird, I've actually never seen this happen. Intercept. I guess it landed. Alright, so I got my dropship. I'm going to send it out. Okay. Yeah, I guess it landed. I've never actually seen one like land like that. Huh. Local authorities. Alright, so if it gets back up, my interceptor's going to nab it otherwise. Oh, okay, so it's over land. So yeah, I guess it landed. Alright, so auto resolve. Alright. You can go into a little battle screen, but I don't know, I don't like it. it's very clunky, and every time I do it, I just blow up my ship. So, and it's not even that interesting. So, alright, so there we go. Shot down the UFO. That guy can go back to the base. Let's see, crash site. Okay, so it's heading there. Alright. There we go. And we'll engage. And this is this part here where you actually moving with your dropship. This is kind of the main part of the game, if you will. It's the fun part. It's the ground combat. When you shoot one down, you can also just sort of do an airstrike on it. But you get some money from that, but you don't get any technology or anything. So, all right. So this is the screen. It's all turn-based. I got my shield guys. I'm gonna keep them out kind of in front. Oh, man, he's right there. All right. So, it's a little bit blocked by the cacti. What about now? Still. Take another step. I'm not sure who died. Or did they recover? I thought I had. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No. Okay. So I got my heavy weapons guy. I have 2 shields. So I guess it was just a rifleman. Between these two, this person looks better. Won't let me? Is my squad full? Am I confused? Oh, they haven't returned yet. Alright. Gotta wait for them to get back before I can mess with that. Alright, speed up time. Come back home. So a pretty good start. Alright, so now I can go in there. Take a look. Alright, so we're missing one person, yeah. And then I'll assign this person in to Charlie 1 as rifleman. We can check him out here. Everybody's doing good now. This heavy weapon guy, I tell you, it's made me a convert. Tore them up. Alright, so the heavy weapon guy is really good. So now, basically you speed up time till something happens. Alright, so they did at the autopsy, and it kind of gives you a nice big description of them. This is where it tells you, basically they have thick skin, resistant to damage, but kind of close range eyesight. You can check out their scout UFO too. Alright, armored car has been researched. So we can go to the research screen, and we're going to work on the pistol first. And now we can work on the scout car. Their new free garage slots, alright. So we need to build a garage. So this is your base, and basically it's just modular. You build whatever you need to build in here. So I'll just pop a garage right there. Take 5 days to build. And up here is where the time runs. It's pretty, you know, like this is actually all happening pretty fast. So even if I speed up, you know, it's just a matter of days. All right, so like 2 days later, there was another UFO. We'll intercept it with our Condors again, launch them out. Oop, we're gonna tail to overland. Speed up a little. Come on, sometimes they never go overland. Oh, there we go. Engage, and these guys are easy. All right, so they're taken down. I think my team's ready. No one's hurt. I do want to go ahead and, since I only have one sort of reserve soldier, I'm going to get a couple more because it takes a few days to get them. So, you know, you don't want to be short on your team. I'm going to get one person with high hit points. What's the qualities in the heavy weapons guy? What's his strength, I imagine? Accuracy. Alright. So I want to make sure I have a guy that can kind of do that. Oops, I didn't hire that last person. So we'll get that person, and then strength. Reflexes, bravery. This one looks a little better. I'll get that one. Maybe one more with a high accuracy. This one has a lot of actually good qualities. Alright, so we'll hire those three. Alright. Oh, hire selected. There we go. And you can see the funds up there. Right now I have 1,447,000. Which doesn't last as long as you would think, because things get expensive. Alright, so let's get the crash site. We can see you can airstrike it for 15,000, but you don't get any research. So it's not something you want to do unless your team is, like, you know, all hurt and you can't deal with it. What I did in my last game is I sort of set up just a little base with those interceptors over here to shoot down the UFOs. Because if you don't shoot them down, they cause problems like this, and the countries get mad. And so I'd shoot them down, I would just do airstrikes. The dropships, so the interceptors, they have a limited range. They'll run out of fuel really quick. The dropships, you can go anywhere in the world, but, you know, if you only have one and you go all the way over there, it can take a long time. I had two my last game. But it was really chewing up the money, and it was kind of spreading me thin. I think it might be better just to have one drop ship and constantly sort of, I don't know, moving around, and then if you have more crash sites, then just do airstrikes on them or whatever. At least for a while. I don't know. I don't know the best way to go for that. All right. Don't have my scout vehicle yet. Bad thing about scout vehicle though is they can't go into the UFO. Alright, so there's some doofus standing out there. And we got a copper over there. Alright. Get the shield guys out front. Alright, urban. Urban's rough. You never know where they're gonna come from. Kind of position him there. Try to get some sight. Oh, there we go, right there. Alright. Go ahead, duck down. Can we get a shot in? No. So this guy's actually in a little bit of a bad situation. Here? No, I think it'll be out of the area. Alright, who do we got? Sniper guy. Sniper guy, I'm going to put him back. I'm afraid of somebody coming in through here. I'm just going to put him... Yeah, I'll put him here. Can we take a shot? It's blocked 100%. Not going to happen. That means he can't shoot there. Where is... Yeah, this dude... Let's get him rolled up, set up here. This guy steps out. Machine gun his face off. And so the other guys, I'm just going to kind of bring up against this wall. I'm actually going to have him look through this window. Looks okay. Have him kind of looking through this window. This is, you know, there could be a guy in here and he pops out and all of a sudden bad things are happening. Okay. Looks good in turn. Somebody's shooting. Where? I don't know. I think there's more guys in that building. That guy's taken off. Who's shooting at him? Was somebody shooting at him from up here? Alright, so this guy ducked into this building. I don't know if these... Oh, these doors do open. Alright. I want him to kind of be here, but kind of looking that way. More like that way. Just to cover that flank. This shield guy, I'm going to run up to his door. Alright, there he is. He's chilling back there. Can I get up here? Not quite. What about here? You know, I'm just gonna duck him there. Alright, my machine gunner, can he get all the way up here? He can. He's gonna hop over that. Oh, there's more. All right. Go there, duck down. Just be ready. Be ready, bro. Bring them up. And can I get up here? Where is this? This is a little raised area. And there's actually a cop in there. Mouse wheel lets you scroll up and down among the levels. Sheesh. Alright, well, I'm just gonna go ahead and kneel down right here. Take a shot. There we go. It's better to be kind of be safe. Where's my other shield guy? Can he move out? Yep. Alright, he might get a better shot. Kneel down. And you can go through several levels, and you see it takes 18 points. The points are right here. And so it takes 18 points for that, 25. It's a better aim. You can see the chance of hitting goes up. So I'll go ahead and do that kind of shot. Missed. These guys are really terrible when they first start. You gotta work them up. Next I want to try to get my sniper back here. That's going to take, I want to save enough for a normal shot, so you can kind of limit your movement. I don't know if that's going to work. Okay, it is. It's a clear shot. Alright, we'll go ahead and take the shot. Alright, 26 damage. There's different kinds of aliens too. These reptile guys, they take quite a bit of damage. They tend to be a lot more deadly up close. Alright, so... Trying to avoid getting guys killed. Do I have any sort of shot here? I can take a little bit. It's unlikely to hit, but... I prefer to be safe. Ooh, got him. Excellent. Alright, I'm gonna just go ahead and move my other guys out. So, we're in... One thing that's really neat about this game, so like this, the crash was in like Central America, Mexico, something like that, and so the environment reflects that. You can see it's like desert and stuff like that. If it crashes near a city, then it'll have like an urban environment. So, alright, so the aliens are out there moving around. It's not too bad at first. It gets hard really quick. So if you kind of mess up, it's kind of snowballs on you. And you gotta be careful too, because these guys, oh that's cool, a little gas station. These guys can really kind of sneak up on you. So you really want to make sure you cover your area as well. All right, so there's a couple civilians. They're suppressed. So that tells me that, you know, somebody's shooting at him over here. Alright, there he is. There's the guy. Very low chance of hitting that. I'm going to take... Oh. Nope, don't have enough. It's red. 18 points. Okay. So, does he have any... Alright, so I can shift him. There's probably no chance at all. Where's my sniper? There he is. Alright, we can move him. I'm going to make sure he has enough for a normal shot. Alright, this is going to be quite a long shot, but snipers can sometimes pull it off. Alright, 55% chance. Nope. Okay. And I'm not too worried about him sort of hitting me from here. Because like I said, they are not very good at long range. Part of their like bio, as you find out as you play, is that they have sort of short range eyesight. Okay, that was nice. This dude. Now, I've never actually used the assault. So he just has burst. So he's not going to be able to shoot. I'm going to kind of move him up as close as I can, and then kneel. And then maybe next round I'll get to do some burst fire. These guys, he can make a normal shot with 17. Do we get a clean shot? No, it says 18. Why is... Oh, because he's not facing. That's the problem. 1 point to move. Alright, so these guys aren't really going to be able to... We'll just get them moved up a little. There we go. Shield guy has a little bit of movement. I'm going to move him... right here. No, right here. Oh, there's another one. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and duck him down there. Alright, those guys, those civilians are kind of screwed. You're supposed to try to protect them, but not much chance of that happening. Ooh, see? That killed my guy right there. Until you get armor, it's pretty much they kill you dead on. Alright, so he's got a burst shot. 27, alright, times 10. Well, he needs 44. He's got some movement, so let's move up. No, he basically doesn't. So let's just shoot. That was pretty good, actually. Wow. Maybe I should start using those guys more. Alright, move up my shield guy. Spotted one over there. I'm gonna move right here. There's a little bit of cover. Duck down, maybe take a normal little pot shot here. Got lucky. Move this guy kinda here. And then duck down. Mostly I want the shield guys to kind of draw the fire. Can't believe they took that dude out like that. Ugh. Alright, move him up. Duck. Let's get these guys behind cover. One thing that really annoys me about this game is if they spot an alien sort of coming towards them, they will sort of react and shoot. Which is fine, except they will shoot each other in the back of the head and stuff, so you can't, you gotta watch how you place them. It's a little retarded. There's no, see, there is a reaction shot. That was a good reaction shot. So in other words, you don't want them in a line, you want them sort of in a line horizontally to targets. Alright, so there's just one right now. I want to try this machine gun guy again. I'm a little afraid for this person. So let's move her down here. Just to make sure this guy doesn't machine gun him. Alright, take a shot. Nice. Machine gunner. I'm actually thinking I should have been using these machine gun guys. Wow. Yeah, they're really good for the open field. That perhaps was part of my problem. Alright, I know there was another one, I think, that ran off that way. The main thing you gotta do is you gotta find the USBO ship. Alright, don't see anybody, but I know there's one over this way. I'll duck him down there. His shield protects him from the front, but if a guy comes up this way, it's kind of bad situation. That person's moved. Alright, these guys will bring up position and cover. This civilian needs to get the hell out. Little cover there. I want to keep an eye on this gas station just in case. Where can you go? Can't quite make it there. Maybe here. It's better than nothing. And duck. And then Mr. Machine Gun Guy. Oop. Just take a step.